So, hello, hello, good afternoon. We just start our live stream, and it will be some kind of the experiment because we are going on both platforms, Facebook and Instagram. So let's check how it works. So, welcome here. Today we have quite interesting topic about how to stop comparing yourself with others. So we can start to dig a little bit deeper and explore. And how are you today? How was your week so far? We have Wednesday. For some of us, they said that Wednesday is almost like a small weekend because it's only Thursday and Friday and it will be the weekend. So welcome on our live, and I just would like to maybe introduce myself at the beginning. So my name is Angelina Piechowska, and I am psychologist and solution-focused brief therapist. And with my dear friend Bonnie Martin, in March 2021, we established the International School of Life. So we help expats, working mom, to build their life abroad, the professional and the private life abroad. And today I would like to speak about very big issue. Like, a lot of people ask me this question during the individual work or on the workshops: how to stop to compare myself with others, especially when we are in the social media world. It's so easy to compare ourselves and feel a little bit worse or even bad. I know that some people even try to unfollow some kind of the accounts because it's not the emotions that they want to feel. So today, during this live, we will be thinking and speaking about the three things. One, the first one is what you can do with your emotions when you are jealous. So what to do if you compare yourself with others and you feel jealous about something. And it's really common feeling, and sometimes it's not so easy to admit, yes, I am jealous, but I want to show you how you can work with this, okay? But in very positive way. The second point will be what to do if you already think like, I want to be like her, I want to be her, I want to have the same life, or I want to be him, I want to have the same life like he is, you know? So when you compare yourself, you have this thought, you have these emotions inside, I want to be like her. Okay? And then the third point will be why you should stop to compare yourself with others. Stop to compare yourself with others. And then we can go through some lessons. We can tick some boxes with the information that we can collect. So, okay, what to do if you feel jealous? And it's very natural emotions, and we all, as a human being, sometimes we are jealous. But the interpretation of these emotions can give you two pathways that you can take, and you can decide what you would. So, firstly, you can feel jealous. And you can stay in the corner, or I don't know, start to cry, or start to moan about your life, or start to think, oh, I will never be at the same in the same place like this person. So this is the one way. On the other side, jealous can be the emotions that you can use to become more motivated about your goals and about your future. But what I want to ask you today, if you are jealous or if you experienced jealous before, think about what is the information underneath this emotion, okay? If you feel jealous, what is the message underneath this emotion? Because probably you are jealous because you have some need. Okay, if you meet your need, you can experience some positive emotions. It's from nonviolent communication approach. Like, each emotions is linked with some need. Like, when you feel happy, for example, maybe the need was to rest, and you rest, and on the end you are happy. So you had a need to rest, and on the end, the result, the emotions, the feelings was that you were happy. Exactly the same when you feel jealous. the jealous, what is the need? Maybe you need the same kind of well-being, or you need the same, like when I am jealous about the person who, for example, developed the business perfectly. Maybe my need is to build some strong organization and deliver the same thing like this person. So the jealousness can help you to discover what kind of need do you have. And then the step should be how you can meet your need, what you can do with it. Okay, makes sense. I hope that it makes some sense for you. But every time when we work with emotions, think about it that emotions were created because they want to bring you some information. Okay, some information that you. So when you feel, for example, calm, let's say. Probably you met your need that you, I don't know, rest or went for some walk. So also link the emotions with the need. And what kind of the need do you have right now? What you should provide for yourself? How you can support yourself with this need to feel the emotions that you want to feel. Okay? Next, what to do if you think, I want to be like her. Okay? Or I want to be like him. This is the good question when you compare yourself to others and you can think, yeah, I really want to live that kind of the life. I want to have that kind of the business. I want to have that kind of the career or that kind of the family. When you think about what I can do to be like her, this is the good way of thinking, because the person that you admire her or admire her skills, this person can become your role model, okay? And when this person became your role model, then you can ask yourself, what kind of this decision she made in the past to become who she is today? Oh, thank you, Cornelia, you are there. Greetings, our beautiful queen. I miss you a lot. What kind of this decision she made that she became that kind of the person? What price she needed to pay? Because somebody is in the different place in their life just because they made this decision, but they admitted, like they committed to make some work to be there. And also learn from her. So you don't have to create any copy of somebody else's life, but you can learn which steps you can take, what kind of the decision you can make, and then from this role model point of view you can follow her steps. So you don't have to create the wheel again. Sometimes we can learn from the mentors or teachers that they are ahead of us. And the first thing that we are speaking about today will be why you should stop to compare yourself to others. And I know that it's hard, and I'm doing it constantly, and probably we are all, as a human beings, we compare ourselves to others. I'm not sure that, are you aware about Desiderata, the beautiful poem from 1927, written by Max Ehrmann, and there is one beautiful sentence that you can remember, or you can remind yourself, because I am pretty sure that a lot of things that I'm talking about today, you already know. And they aren't new stuff for you or the new subject. But as Suzuki Roshi said, the most important thing is remember about the most important thing. So I hope that during these lives that I would like to deliver almost every Wednesday, you will remind yourself what is really important and what you want to stick with. So in Desiderata, in this poem, you can find one sentence, and I really want to encourage you to find this text, Desiderata, and try to read it very peacefully, because it's very mindful text and it's a text that you can go through and meditate during reading this text. Okay. So, one quote that I want to mention is, if you compare yourself with others, you may become vain or bitter, for always there will be greater and lesser person than yourself. Okay? So, from the logical point of view, when you compare yourself with others, always will be somebody who will be better than you, prettier than you, I don't know, will have more money than you, will have better, whatever you can imagine. Okay? And it will always be the person who will be worse, like she or he will have less money or she will have different life. And so from logical point of view, it doesn't make sense, because always you can find a person on the two poles of the same subject. Somebody will be better, somebody will be worse. So the only thing that you can stick with and you can do is to compare yourself to yourself. Okay? So compare yourself to yourself. Who have you been 5 years ago? Okay? Ask yourself this question. What was your starting point? Okay? Like, for example, for me, when I think about 2016, 5 years ago, I didn't speak English at all. Okay? I didn't speak English at all. So when I think about today, okay, it's okay. I'm speaking English, maybe not fluent, maybe not brilliantly, and I am aware I'm still making mistake. But to compare myself with Angelina from 2016, I am on my pathway. I made some progress. If I will compare myself today to the different people, maybe they have different and better level of English. And some of them maybe don't speak English at all still. So what is the point to compare myself to others? Doesn't make sense. It's just to compare myself to myself. And sometimes my last beautiful manager that I am in the, like, she's my really good friend right now. Sometimes she call me and say, Angelina, well done you for being you. And I think, well done we for being who we are. And just to think about the journey that you took during the last couple of years. Okay. And one thing that I want to really, really highlight, because it's important. It's very often, and you can tell me if you experience the same or if you are doing the same. But very often when we compare ourselves with others, we choose one element from their life. Like, okay, so she has BMW and I have the old Ford. Or she has, I don't know, mansion on the seaside and I have some small flat, I don't know, in the city center or whatever. We choose one element and we compare it. And it's almost like we compare somebody else's exhibition with our backstage. And we don't take into consideration the whole picture. So very often, because I'm psychologist and solution-focused brief therapist, so I work with people and I have the individual sessions with them. And I met people who drove BMW and came from the beautiful mansion with the swimming pool inside, and they suffer for depression. And I met people who had barely survived until the next salary, and they were the most happy people that I met. So we are so different. We have such a different personalities. We have such a different character. We are so, so different. So why we choose this specific element to compare ourselves? Take into consideration the whole picture about your life or about her life. Because, okay, maybe somebody else can drive BMW or Mercedes and you have the old Ford, let's say. But maybe you have a job or you have real mission or you have real passion and you help others. And this is the way of your life. This is your ikigai. Maybe this is a reason for being alive. Maybe she's driving her BMW, but she is suffering in her job every day from Monday to Friday. She cannot forget about Saturday, like when the weekend will come, because she isn't happy. And I think that it can be related to your own definition of success. What is your definition of success? How you will recognize, okay, this is the moment, this is the point in my life when I am successful, okay? Because this is the story about. For example, when I compare myself and the job that I'm doing, the role that I was doing in the last couple of years, when I help people with in some deep crisis in Birmingham, and I thought, okay, my salary compared to my colleagues, for example, in the business areas, I work for the charities, was much, much bigger. But for example, on my list was more than 100 people who experienced homelessness. And for me, my mission was to help them. And during the, I think, almost 3 years, from this more than 100 people, only few stayed on the street. Because I help them, I try to help them because of the beautiful team and beautiful team, people who help me, we help those people. So when you compare only account and when we compare the money, okay, I am not so successful, like probably she or he is better, but I follow my mission. It was my mission to help somebody else and I fulfill this mission and I feel great. And I don't think so that I will feel greater with BMW. I will feel greater if I will have another 100. And this is the story about me. And I don't want to say that, oh, I hate money. I love money. I want to go abroad. I want to go for a nice vacation. But the money, for it isn't the source of success and the source of happiness for me. And I check it. Because guys, before I became psychologist, I worked 9 years for General Electric, GE Money Bank. This is the big corporation when you can do a big money. It wasn't my piece of cake. And I changed it. So whatever you compare, take into consideration. And very often we judge people by the cover, like you judge a book by the cover and we judge people by cover. Okay, she achieved or she had brilliant career or beautiful house or beautiful family and I'm going through divorce or I'm going through some tough moment, but you don't know, maybe she has this beautiful mansion, but maybe she's struggling with some illness. We don't know about it. So don't choose this element to compare yourself because it doesn't make sense. And on the end, I want to leave you with some metaphor, with some beautiful story. I love the stories because you can forget the numbers, you can forget the facts and the research, but you will always remember the story. And please, this is the moment when you should remember the story. So the story is about the Buddha, the beautiful monument of Golden Buddha that was found in Thailand. And many, many years, this monument was hidden. Because they were afraid that somebody will stole this monument. Because this monument was built from the pure gold. Okay, so it was the biggest monument of Golden Buddha. And then found it because some of the people found it that because it was covering but by a lot of things, but underneath this cover stuff, they found out that it's a light. And when they tried to open it more, it was obvious that it's a golden monument. And I think that it's exactly the same with us. Everybody has some goldenness inside and some light inside of us. And the only work to do and the only job to do is to give yourself permission and give yourself access, okay? To this goldenness inside of you. You have to find it and you have to trust it. And no matter that somebody else will be, you know, will have more shiny goldenness, it's more about you, about your potential, about your ikigai, about your reason of being alive, and stick to your pathway. Trust to yourself and stick to your values. And don't forget, always will be somebody who is better, always will be somebody who isn't so good like you. So from the logical point of view, it doesn't make any sense to compare yourself to others. Ladies, thank you today for the listening. And this is the part of the International School of Life. And we would like to invite you for the webinar about the confidence. So if you would like to work with your confidence, if you want to stop to procrastinate, or if you think how to deal with the criticism, how to work with your inner critic, how to move forward, how to stay motivated, how to boost your confidence, please join us. Webinar is for free, 1st of December. You can sign up. The link is in bio. And thank you today, ladies, for being with me. It was very supportive to have you all here, especially that I know you. I know you all. So thank you. And I hope that it was helpful or useful. Hello. And gentlemen, I'm sorry. And we have one gentleman. So, yeah, thank you for today. Hopefully see you next Wednesday. Next Wednesday, we will be speaking about procrastination. So why do we procrastinate? And I think that it will be quite insightful, alive, because behind procrastination, it's only one thing, only one emotion, only one feeling. And I will be speaking a lot about emotions because, unfortunately, I am a psychologist and I love to speak about emotions. So have a lovely, lovely Wednesday. All the best for you. Stick to your pathway. Thank you for being with me today. All the best and see you soon.